stock and total assets are 10 lakhs, and the equity side you have 10 lakhs, so that matches perfectly fine. Now, what do you think would be there in the profit and loss account before opening the data cost statement? Can you tell what will be there in the profit and loss account?
Zero.
Okay, yeah, that's correct, because we are not made any sales transaction yet. Once we do the sales transaction, we'll have some entries in the profit and loss statement. Now, can you open the cash flow statement?
There is a global defaults settings are there where you can define your this company as a default. So everywhere this company would be filtered out.
Okay, I will change.
That will save us some time. Yeah. So here you have a net change in cash 6,27,000. So good that you mentioned this. I think you also sent me a message yesterday about it. So when I in my instance, incidentally, I'm seeing net change in cash is negative. Simply because net cash from financing is not appearing. I don't know why it is not appearing in my case, but what you we see in your instance is seems to be more correct because 10 lakh is invested, that cash has come in, and some cash has gone out in operation because in buying inventory. So we have some net changes actually positive. So what we see is here is correct. In my instance, it is not correctly captured. I don't know what was the error. But because of that, one quiz question, you may get it wrong.
Yeah.
So I'll correct the quiz. No issue with that, and you should get the correct score there. I don't know whether I can do it now once people started giving it, but the whole idea of our quiz is to check whether the numbers are coming consistently on. So we could spot that this is the change. So fair enough. I think we are done. Just because your instance is complete, it will be a good idea to see the stock ledger and general ledger for everybody's benefit. You just show the stock ledger and general ledger.
This is my stock ledger.
Yes, so this is how the stock ledger looks like, and this is in the quantity, out quantity, balance quantity. So it's correct. And then I think we should also look at general ledger, where it should show all the accounting entries. You can just type in there. General ledger, yeah. General ledger, not general ledger.
Okay.
sorry, general ledger, not journal. General
Okay.
GE.
Okay.
So general ledger is where we see all the entries. Now we don't see any entries because of the company's so now we don't see any entries over here, but if you click on that show opening entries box, there is a in the filter, you will see show opening entries. There's a checkbox over there.
Where it is?
Just go a little up. So where you selected a company, yeah, just below that it will show. Now you see all the entries. So we had had a tick mark when we did a JV. This is the opening entry. So typically opening entries are like a one-time thing. You are not supposed to refer to it again and again. So that are generally hidden. But in our case, since we are starting, we will have this opening entry. We need to see whether we have done it correctly. And we could see that, yes, stock reconciliation has happened and all. Okay, so seem to be okay. Perfect. So thank you, Vaishali. Do you have any questions?
No, I don't have any questions.
Okay, fair enough. So you can stop sharing. Let me follow my sequence, a sequence in my Excel. So the next person is Swati. So Swati, just confirm whether you are done, not done. Are you doing it now? Are you there? She's Swati, are you there in the meeting? We're not getting any response from Swati, so. Okay, so we'll move on. I'm just making some marking here that it's done for Vaishali. Snehal, are you there? I guess Snehal is also not there. Anirudh, are you there? He's also not there. Shivangi? She's also not there. Saili? Saili is not ready. Okay. Ruturaj? Yeah. Ruturaj, can you share your screen now?
Yes, sir. Okay, just one entry is remaining from my side for journal entry. Okay. One I have created.
Okay, so you have created one journal entry, which is opening balance. Yes. Can you just open that?
Okay.
Okay, just go down and click on the more information. More information. Yeah, so you have to tick that. You didn't tick it. You did. Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Fair enough. So you need to do other entries, right?
Yes. For that, there is no option to select bank here.
Okay. Now go to your chart of accounts. Go to your chart of accounts. Go to assets. Yes. And you have current assets. So bank account should be in the current assets. We go there. There's a bank account there. Click there.
There is no child.
Achha, it's not there. Okay. Yes. Then add child. Just click add child. Choose whatever bank, whichever bank you like to name.
Okay.
Okay. So account number is not required. Account type, you can just mention bank. Just click the bank there. Yes, account type. I think rest is okay. You have companies. Oh, okay, Patil Companies. That's perfect. So you just create new. And you're good to go. Now you can go ahead and do it.
Okay, sir.
We'll come back to you later.
Okay.
Ashish, yeah. So you can stop sharing and we'll ask Ashish to share his screen. Yes, Ashish. Are you done or are you facing any difficulty?
Yeah, I'm actually facing difficulties in creating those entries, sir. I've created item list, customers and suppliers also here. I've completed stock reconciliation.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can you show the chart of accounts?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, you got some 12 lakh rupees. That is same
no,
company?
No, that is not the company. This is Indictrans, sir. And I'm not able to change the company also here, sir.
So just click, where is your company? Is it not appearing here?
No, it's not appearing.
How many companies? So just go on company and see how many companies you have got there.
Oh,
So go to search box and type company. Yeah, company list. You got two of you. Okay.
Yeah.
So you are working with AR industry essentially.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So again, go to chart of accounts and we'll see. So it can select and delete it. No, if you don't see it there.
No, it's not getting the other names.
Okay. So you go to financial statements and just pick up balance sheet. Just check balance sheet. Yeah, there you just change that. Okay. Looks like you have mixed up some entries. I think some entries are gone in this company, some got this gone on the Indictrans company.
But every time I created any entries, I selected AR Industries only, sir.
Yeah, but if you go to the Indictrans, you also see some entries there, some amounts there, right?
Yeah, it was already there, sir. I did not select this company. It was already there.
Just go down, just see what are these 12 lakhs coming from. Go down in the Indictrans itself. Go down. The stock has gone in there actually. In the Indictrans company.
Okay.
So what I would suggest is now you clean up your instance in a way. You can delete either one of these entries.
Okay.
Either one of these companies, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, okay, so are you able to just go to this company? In your company or Indictrans, either one of it. Just say company list. Click any one of these companies. Just click there inside. Go inside. Yeah. Just go down. Then you will see a red button somewhere. Yeah, there's a red button here. Okay. So don't click it right now. Just decide which company you want to work with.
Okay,
you
okay.
Choose one of this company. It doesn't really matter. The name doesn't really matter. And you can change the name also.
Okay.
Because so I think it looks like there are some mixed up that has happened.
Okay.
So you could start from scratch in a way, I would suggest, instead of correcting these things.
Okay.
You could choose which company you want to retain.
Mm-hmm.
Other company can simply delete. And the company you're doing, just delete all transactions there.
Okay.
I guess your master will remain. That should not go away. Your opening balance will get clear.
Okay, sir.
So do that and then we'll come back to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Rishikesh. Rishikesh, are you there? Yes. Do you want to show the screen? Do you have any difficulty, or you are doing on your own and you are fine to do it? I think you said that you added something, but bit concern opening entry. So do you want to show your screen? Okay. So just go ahead. Meanwhile, let me just respond to Dhananjay. So Dhananjay, it's good idea to go to chart of accounts for creating new ledger. I'm not aware of any shortcut which is there to put in general voucher or any other payment voucher. Preferably do it through, I only know one way, that is through chart of accounts. There could be some shortcut, but I'm not aware of it at least. But if you get to know some shortcut, please let me know, or let the class know in a way. But as of now, I know that you have to go to the chart of accounts for creating new ledger. Okay. So Rishikesh, will you? Yes, your screen is visible. Can you just show the? Yeah. Okay. Something. Some issue somewhere. Okay. Can you show chart of accounts? Open chart of accounts, please. You have got 4 lakh as a current assets. What about your liabilities in the owner's equity? Can you just check? Have you passed that entry, owner's equity? In the source of funds, you can go down and capital account is what you can check. Okay. Shareholder funds, here we see shareholder funds. So it seems you didn't pass that entry of balance equity, which you should have obviously passed for shareholder fund, which is not what he has done. So that entry is pending. Okay. But I'm a little worried, how did you get this 4 lakh for the current assets? It should be something like a 3 lakhs kind of thing. Okay, your mic is not working, looks like. Okay. So from stock reconciliation, just open your stock reconciliation. Okay, so thanks Vaishali. So Vaishali has helped Dhananjay saying that you can create new account through voucher entry. Yes, I guess when you're typing it. Okay, good Vaishali. Dhananjay just try it out, otherwise Vaishali can help. We'll ask Vaishali to share the screen and share it, tell you how to do it. But I'm sure when you are dropping down this account, there it must be given link for new account. So just try that out and come back to us. Okay, meanwhile, let us look at Rishikesh. Yeah, okay, so you took a different. Okay, so Rishikesh, are you following the same numbers or different numbers? No, what I meant to say, in Excel data, we have given these numbers, right? Laptop, desktop, and those kind of a thing. Are you following that? Or because we see some different items over here. Okay. So that's why the numbers are different. Okay. Okay. Rishikesh, what I would suggest for the time being, just follow the numbers or the details that are given there. In the Excel sheet, because then it will help us to compare and see what the problems are, right? So you may kind of what I suggest, you just use that red button to get rid of all the transactions and just follow all the numbers as per the Excel sheet. I think that will be easy. If you want to change the numbers, so what I actually said earlier is that you should change the numbers if you're comfortable or confident about ERP Next. You know it. I think some of you already have some good experience in working ERP Next. You could play with those numbers. But if you're new to ERP Next, let us follow the standard numbers given in the Excel that I'm sharing, so that we can troubleshoot faster. I mean, you can still troubleshoot, but you can troubleshoot faster if you follow the same numbers. So please do that. So, yeah, so just ping us once you're done. I mean, I will call upon you again in the sequence. So by then, I hope you should be done. Thank you. Okay, Ashish said the recorded lecture, the last session is not available on YouTube. I request you to upload it. Okay, so the request goes to Gupteshwar actually to check, you know, because I'm not uploading those videos. I think somebody else is uploading. So
yeah, we'll ensure that.
Yeah, so
thanks. Noted.
Yeah, thanks. Okay, so we'll move to the next person. Let me just make a mark, his work in progress. Ravi, are you there? Rishikesh, you can stop sharing. Ravi, are you there? Ravi, can you hear me? I see you in the list of the participants. Can you at least unmute or type in the chat box to acknowledge that you are there? Okay, I'm not getting any response. Okay, we'll go to Sumit. So Sumit had raised his hand saying that it's complete. Sumit, can you just share your screen? We'll just see how things are.
Yes, sir. My screen is in the
way. Yeah, it's just coming in. Yeah.
Sir, I am working. I am just concerned with the general entries with some points, but I do that, sir. But some of the points are in green.
Okay, this you are not submitted?
Because some error is.
Hold on. Because what you are trying. No, don't do that. Okay. Because you had only entered State Bank of India twice. You should have temporary accounts, right? Just go and check the Excel, the spreadsheet that I shared.
Yes. I will.
It should be temporary opening in credit.
Oh.
But just hold on. Just go back again to your ERP next. Now, please note. Just hold on for a minute here. See, what we have done, we have got 10 lakh rupees in the bank to begin with, okay? Then, this is your company, right? So, you started with 10 lakh rupees, right, as equity, right? Then you did some stocks, bought some stocks, right, which is what you got in with stock reconciliation, right? So, what is the amount that you left in bank? Will it be 1 lakh rupees? You have shown 1 lakh rupees. Is it 1 lakh or some other amount? I put a question mark purposely there. You need to make that calculation.
Yes.
If you started with 10 lakh, whether it's not 1 lakh, you started with 10 lakh, right? And you have got some stock in hand, right? So that amount is there. You bought some stock in hand. Now, what is the amount that you'll have in the bank? That calculation you have to do. And then you have to pass this entry.
Okay.
Are you getting me?
Yes.
So please do that. I mean, you may consult others also. So I will give you, we can stop sharing. Just think through it. If you want, you can talk to someone else to get a clarity on it. But you need to first decide that amount and then make a entry accordingly.
Okay.
And just to ensure that you have a bank and a temporary account against you. Good. So I just put Sumit work in progress. This is how we learn. I mean, I know it's a little painful that we are kind of stuck here, but I think this is how we learn. You also learn it a little hard way, but you remember it. Okay, Ramakrishna, can you share your screen?
Is it visual?
Not yet. I guess it will take some time.
Is it visual, sir?
Yes, it is coming. Yes, perfect. Okay, so you got Bank of Maharashtra. How much you got in Bank of Maharashtra? You got 3 lakhs?
Actually, I have put that amount, sir. I don't know how to keep, but I have keep it manually. I don't do any calculation for that.
Just a minute. Let me. Yes, can you please repeat what did you say?
That 3 lakh amount was put by me. I didn't do any calculation for that.
Yes, because I purposely didn't give you all the entries on your plate. What I said is that, okay, you invested, got 3,72,000 in stock. So, and you have 10 lakh rupees as a stock market investment. So remaining amount should come here. Okay. So just, just check your temporary accounts, how much it is now, temporary accounts. Yeah, it is not, so you have that hint over there also. Okay, perfect. Okay, so you can stop sharing now. You can do those changes and we will come in next round to you. Okay, Monica, could you do all the changes by now, all the entries by now?
Yes, sir. Maine sare changes kar liye, matlab done kar liya hai maine successfully.
अच्छा सो आपने सब एंट्रीज अभी कर लिया है?
यस सर.
ओके, जस्ट शेयर योर स्क्रीन एंड शो हाउ डज योर चार्ट ऑफ अकाउंट लुक्स लाइक.
यस सर. सर स्क्रीन इज विजिबल?
या इट्स कमिंग अप. यस आई कैन सी दैट. Need computers. So we have got current assets 13 lakhs. Bank account you have got 10 lakhs. So you can't have.
सर मैंने जस्ट न्यू बैंक क्रिएट किया है बैंक ऑफ महाराष्ट्र और उसमें 10 लाख.
हाँ, कैसा है से आपने जब अकाउंट कंपनी शुरू किया 10 लाख डाल राइट यू पुट 10 लाख रुपीस इन द बैंक आई मीन यू स्टार्टेड विद द 10 लाख रुपीस इक्विटी.
यस.
देन यू बॉट सम स्टॉक व्हिच इज अराउंड 3,72,000 राइट.
ओके,
सो योर बैंक विल नॉट हैव 10 लाख रुपीस, इट विल हैव लेस अमाउंट.
ओके.
So in Excel that I gave, I didn't give that amount. I just put a question mark, and I mentioned yes. last time that you have to calculate how much money will be there in the bank once you already once you have that kind of stock, right?
Okay.
So that is the challenge. So if you know, are you fresher or are you
fresher?
Okay. Then what I would suggest, you can use that red button. Or your stock reconciliation is correct, right? Okay. So maybe you can you need to change these entries. So you can delete these entries and recreate the entry. That should work out. We'll see that. Just try doing it once.
Okay, sir.
And we'll come back to you next round. You got the problem, no? What is the problem?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thanks.
Srikant, I have a question. Can we reverse the accounting entry?
You should actually reverse accounting entry, but that much we are not kind of learned in the training program. So for the time being, you can delete it, which is not absolutely should not be allowed. I mean, we should always reverse the entry. But at credit debit, I'm sure people get confused. So I'm just asking people to delete it for the time being. We are very new in the game. But ideally, you should reverse the entry. So if you make wrong entries, you should pass the reverse entries. Because you should never delete anything from here.
Yeah. In ERP, we should not delete anything.
For the time being, we're just deleting because I think we're making some mistakes. So we'll do that.
Okay.
In first 2-3 cycles, we do it. Then later onwards, we'll try to see how we should do the reversing into us.
Okay.
Okay. Monica is okay. The next is Rahul. Rahul, are you there? Okay, so you are doing now. Okay, so we'll not ask you to share your screen now. Once you are done, you can tell us. Ashutosh, are you done? Are you there? Ashutosh, have you done the entries by now?
No, sir.
Okay, you're doing it right now?
I'm doing other work now. I'll do it later in a day.
Fair. Nupur, could you do it by now? So, or you have a difficulty? If you have difficulty, you can share the screen and ask the questions. Nupur, are you there? I think Nupur is not in the call. Dhananjay, are you done by now? Dhananjay, are you there?
No, sir.
Yeah. Did you finish all the entries?
No, sir. No, sir. Need some time.
Can you share your screen?
Actually, I just created a company and I created a ledger, customer list and ledger, closing ledger, closing stock ledger.
Okay, so it's just still work in progress.
Huh.
Okay, fair enough. We'll come back to you later. Okay. So by now, only Vaishali is done. Let me call back on the people from whom I didn't get response earlier. So Swati, are you there? I just want to know the status. Have you done it, doing it, having any difficulty? So this call is for Swati. Incidentally, I see two twice her name, Swati's name. Okay, we're not sure whether she's there or any network issues. So let us move on. Snehal, are you there? I think Snehal is also not there. Aniruddha, could you do it by now? He's also not there actually. Shubhangi? She's also not in the session. No response. Rahul? He's not there. No, he's there on the screen. Rahul, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you're doing it, right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So let me just put it. Okay. So it's almost 10:30. So we're only Vaishali done. So what we'll do, let us wait. I don't think we can do anything new today. So those who are done can leave. That is actually only Vaishali who could leave. But I would suggest that everybody who is not yet done should stay back in the session so that you could do it, confirm it, and then make a move. Gupta says it's fine. I mean, I don't think we'll be ready to start anything new today. So we'll just ensure that everybody is reached that stage, and then. In next session, we'll do GST settings.
Yeah, Shrikant Kanaiya here.
Yeah.
So let's, as everyone knows, this is the one of the important step, and unless we complete this, it doesn't make sense to move further. So let everyone complete that step, as you are saying. Yeah, it is very much correct. Somewhere yeah. I am seeing people are not that serious. They are just. Coming here for and putting their 90 minutes, and I don't know whether they are taking it seriously or not. So I will be having a separate call with them definitely. But let's ensure we cross this stage, then only we will move to the next step. Otherwise, we will not move to the next step.
Yes, sure. Thank you. Okay. So right now only Swati, Vaishali has a privilege to leave the meeting. I mean, you are done. For rest of the people, you are supposed to continue till you finish and then can leave the meeting. So we'll not be covering anything new. We'll not start with GST studying today for sure. We'll do it in next time. So I'm here on call. So any difficulty, please unmute yourself, raise your hand, and then share your screen and we'll see that. Yeah. So let us troubleshoot for next half an hour.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Ashish.
Yeah, I'm trying to delete the company, sir, but it says insufficient permissions to delete the company.
Yeah, can you just share your screen?
Yeah.
Yes, we can see your screen.
Here I put the company name which I want to deliver.
Yeah, can you open that? It's your ERP next. Ashish, can you share your ERP next screen?
Yes, just a second. Just a second. Is it visible, sir?
Yeah, it's coming in. Yes, now I can see this.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have an administration password for this?
Yes, I got a password to log in actually. I don't know what is administration password.
Okay, so hold on. So just I will try to do it. I'll log into your instance and I'll try to do it. Just hold on for a minute. Just give me a couple of minutes. I will do it. I'll log into your ERP and check it out.
Yeah.
So you were deleting your own company's details, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Because I tried to delete the both, but it required some permissions, sir.
Okay. Let me check whether I can do that.
You can delete anyone of then sir.
We'll stick to one company should we delete this AR company so that you can work
yes,
in Indicus?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
No issues.
Well, try to that.
So, sir, can I ask how does that interest go into that Indictrans account, sir?
Yeah, just give a minute. I should have I have the taxes. So let me just see. Okay, so I have cleared all the deleted company transactions. So I had access to it, administrative access to your instance. So now just refresh this. Oh,
it's still there.
8 minutes. Let me refresh from my side also. Let me reload actually. Sorry, I have not deleted the company. I deleted the company transactions.
Okay.
So AR industries will have a clear now. So you can just go and check with AR industries chat up account. It should be clear now.
Not able to select this company here, sir.
That is tricky. Okay, let me do one thing. Just give me 2 more minutes.
Sir, while I was creating those items, sir, master item, there was an option like maintain stock.
Okay, so what I've done, I've deleted all transactions from New Indictrans also. Okay, so what I would suggest you use New Indictrans only.
Okay.
Just refresh here. Can you just see whether everything is on there?
Yeah.
Just refresh here. Chat of accounts, you can go and look at. Then in chat of accounts, you could see whether there should not be any transaction in chat of accounts. Refresh here.
Yeah.
So work with New Indictrans in this.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And just ensure that master data is there properly. And
okay.
The master data must be there. It will not get clear. Now you do the all opening transactions and first do stock reconciliation.
Yes, sir.
Find the difference what you should have in a bank. Then accordingly do opening balance for bank as well as for the balance equity.
Okay, sir. Can I ask sir?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll do it, sir, and wherever I get queries, I'll ping you, sir.
Sure. No. So I am on the call. So. If you have any difficulty, just I'm going mute, but if you have any difficulty, just ask me.
Hello, sir. Hello, sir.
Yeah, Dukaraj. Yes.
I have calculated the amount for second journal entry.
Mm-hmm. What is that amount?
6,27,000. 250.
Perfect.
Is this okay?
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, thank you.
Ashish.
Yes, sir.
I have deleted the other company, the AR thing.
Okay.
So now you have only one company, IndirectTrans, where you can put all your transactions.
Yes. Okay, sir. Yeah.
Okay.
हेलो सर.
यस आशीष
सर, कैन यू प्लीज शो अस वन फुल ट्रांजैक्शन सर वंस अगेन प्लीज.
ओके
या
लेट मी डू दैट. Yes, what do you want to see? Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir, you can see.
Yeah, what do you want to see?
Sir, as we have entered the master data here, customers and suppliers also, we'll do after that stock reconciliation, right, sir?
Stock reconciliation, yes.
Yeah, okay, so there, while creating stock reconciliation, there is an option of a difference account. Yeah, so what should we select there, because it's giving some pop-up. Liabilities or asset type of account there.
Yeah, so in stock reconciliation, can you see the screen?
Yes. Yeah.
So this is, I actually passed two entries. You can actually pass one entry, not pass two different entries. But any of the entries, the difference account should be mentioned as a temporary opening.
Okay.
Yeah, because that is what, since we're opening it, we want that it should go in temporary opening.
Okay.
The credit debit will happen correctly and you will get it later. Because all the entries are done, this temporary opening will become zero.
Okay, and there is option of purpose also there.
Purpose?
Yeah.
That is opening stock.
Okay.
That is opening stock.
We should not select the stock reconciliation.
No, this is opening stock. So we are using stock reconciliation for doing opening stock.
Okay. And
so let me just check that again. Here you are saying purpose.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. It should be opening stock.
What if we select the other option?
Then stock reconciliation is not applicable here. I mean, that's not the right thing to do. Because we are using this stock reconciliation transaction for opening stock. There is no stock already there. We're just using it for opening stock. So going forward, when we do stock reconciliation, actual stock reconciliation, which means checking the physical world, checking what is the stock there, and then checking with the digital world, and then just putting the whatever needs to be done. So, for example, if you do stock reconciliation, you will go and put all the items and the quantity, which are different from what we have. And there the difference account will be stock adjustment. Because, for example, if you have you show 300 quantity in your system, but right now you have only 250. So somewhere you have to adjust the difference, right?
Yeah.
That difference will go in stock adjustment. So that is where the stock reconciliation to be used. When you go to opening stock, then you have to use difference amount to count as temporary. So you see the change happening here.
Yes.
Okay. So Nupura asked question. For first stock entry, always temporary is selected as a difference account. Yes, for opening stock, Nupur, it has to be opening stock as a purpose, and then the difference account will be temporary account. Rishikesh says, hello sir, do we have to add liabilities also? So there is no liabilities right now. We are opening stock. We have stock back. Capital stock, which is actual liability in a way. But that's all we have. We don't need to add any liabilities. Is that answer your question, Rishikesh? Does that answer your question? Okay, we have 4 minutes to go, so I don't think everybody will to finish by 11. What I suggest is, if you get any difficulty, please use Telegram group to ask your questions. You may put a screenshot if required, just to show ask questions. So please feel free to use. I mean, one of the things that we do with ERP Next also, there's a discussion forum where people ask questions, and it's an art actually. To ask the question in a way that you also share the relevant screens, hiding some of the sensitive information. So you can start using this group, WhatsApp group like that, where you could ask questions. And I would request those who are done, particularly Vaishali and others who have kind of done enough, could ask, answer those questions. So please don't wait for me to answer. I want those who are done, and by the way, those who have kind of learned the hard way, doing things learned the hard way, like, okay, this is not a way to delete things and go back and do it. I'm sure you remember it much longer. And if you help others, it will also help you to remember and learn. So please feel free to answer those questions. So let us use this Telegram group very effectively in next 2 days, because in next session, we definitely want to start with GST setting and sales cycle. But for that, everybody has to finish. At least the 18 names that I have will need to finish all the opening entries, finish stock reconciliation, obviously, and the master entries. So then and then only we'll start. So I want to ensure that all 18 of you who are supposed to do it seriously till the end kind of go together. Any one of you have a challenge, you can talk to your immediate supervisor and see how you could, if you could release from the standing crop, that's fine. It's like a project in a way, right? We are in the project, so we need to do it together. So let us use the Telegram group effectively to ask questions. Those who know the answer, please respond. And if you happen to make a wrong answer, I mean, that's fine. I mean, I will correct, so don't worry. But let us have the spirit of sharing, and helping each other. So let us do that, and then the next session, I hope everybody would be there. please also answer the quizzes. As I said, what are the question about cash flow statement? You may get it wrong, which is fine. Quiz 4 onwards, we are basically checking. I mean, let me also explain what will happen next quiz. We are only checking whether once you have done it, whether you're getting the right figures or not. That's rather the quizzes are. It's more for me also to figure out whether whatever you have done is correct or not. So if you get any mistake there, you should kind of check with me whether there's something wrong in your system. So that's the purpose of those quizzes. So please appear for that quiz also. So I will also confirm that you have finished all your entries correctly. Yeah, you may get one or two wrong, which is fine. Don't worry too much about it. But if you feel something is seriously wrong, you can just put it, ask the question in the group. Yeah? So with this, let us close today's session. I mean, today's session was a really working session in a way. Let us hope next time onwards we'll have some more things going. Yes, Chaitali, you have raised your hand.
Actually, sir, if this training part is done, I want to ask one question regarding stock. Yesterday I posted on that forum group. If possible, can I share my screen? Because I don't want to interrupt the training. That's why I didn't say anything.
Yeah, fair enough. Let me just respond to Rishikesh. I think he has
Sure. Yeah, fine.
So Rishikesh, Alisa, could you please check once where I'm wrong? Chaitral, is it okay if I just ask Rishikesh to share his screen first and we'll resolve that? Let us close the...
No issues. Yes.
Okay, thank you. Rishikesh, please share your screen. Yes, Rishikesh. You have got bank account. You have got bank account 10 lakh. You have got cash in hand, which is 10 lakh. Rishikesh, you seem to have made few mistakes. Your bank account is minus 10, cash in hand is 10, stock is 3. Okay, thing is not correct. Just can you go to the ledger, general ledger. Yes, So you have made a journal entry, which is this. So can you open the journal entry? Just click on that voucher number in that general ledger. There should be a link somewhere. I think the voucher number should have a link. Yes, you can click on that. Yes. What you have done is you have... So if you refer to this Excel sheet, it will show that you have to have ABC1 is a bank account, right? That is bank. You have to do debit there, but there's a question mark. That question mark is there because I have not given you amount. This is a story where we are saying that person has started with 10 lakh rupees is a stock, and then already bought some stock, finished goods, laptop, desktop, and everything. So you need to calculate how much is remaining in the bank. Okay, so that number is not given there. It can't be 10 lakh rupees because 10 lakh rupees is what he started with or she started with. And now you got some amount left in the bank. So that amount you have to calculate. It should be against debit accounts, not against cash, because that entry has to be passed against debit accounts. So please make that correction. Can you just show your uh all journal entries. Is it the only journal entry that you made? Can you just click on journal entry list? Yeah. Okay, you also need to pass the entry for the stock, capital stock that you have, shareholder funds. You need to pass that entry. So open that Excel, you will see that there are two opening entries. Okay, the opening balance equity, that name of the account would be different for you. It could be opening balance equity, or it could be a stock, capital stock, or it could call shareholder fund. Just verify that and just check the chart of account before you make that entry. So that entry is also missing with you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You can stop sharing. You're welcome. Yes, Chaitra.
Sure, sir. Thank you. I'm presenting my screen.
Yes.
So to give you the background and others may not be, I don't think so they'll understand, but let's hope. So we have one use case where we are doing stock in and stock out.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a use case where they want to make in backdated entries
mm-hmm.
Into the system. So I'm making an analysis what all are its impacts in the according to ERP Next. So mm-hmm. Earlier they were having this stock settings allow negative stock was checked.
Mm-hmm.
But now the thing is they don't want this checkbox mm-hmm. to an existing data, and we have agreed that they will make all the entries to zero, and then they will move forward with disabled checkbox.
Mm-hmm.
But now the thing is I have made some of the entries in my this system. So where I have one warehouse, source warehouse, from there I'm making a transfer to other warehouse. So mm-hmm. if you look at this entry I have made, this is 20th and this is 25th. So item was this milk item. And this version is 9.2 we are using. Mm-hmm. So what happened? This balance quantity is showing -100 here. What happened? I have taken 500 into my stock on 25th. Then I have done stock deduction of -100 on 20 min. Then the balance quantity is showing 400, and then I again started doing deducting outgoing quantity was like my. So that time my stock balance was showing 400 values when I have not done this fourth row entry. And when I'm about to make fourth row entry, so I ideally should get an pop-up saying your warehouse is having 400, you can't make the transaction. But it allowed, and the balance quantity on the ledger is zero. But and on the stock balance, it is showing -100.
Okay, so just show the stock balance will be -100 because you allowed them to negative thing that the ledger is showing as zero.
No, but I have stopped allow negative. That means the stock needs to be physically present. Then only I can do the outgoing stuff, right? But I see in some of the cases where there are two cases here, that we can do purchase order, purchase receipt, my stock gets up, and then delivery note, my stock gets out. So that one case, and here I'm doing with the help of stock entry. So I'm able to see different behavior, and basically with the different backdated dates, one option, and this allow negative stock. So my question is, if I select the date range on stock ledger and stock balance same, so what needs to be compared? Like this minus 100 needs to be compared, I mean, with the last row, or this is something like I have, if we come from, if we go from bottom to top, then something like minus 100 is going, it is showing 400, then 500 is coming, then it is showing 500, then 500 is going, and then it is showing zero. How to compare these two reports is one question. And the other thing, if anything goes wrong in this between, do we have any can we correct those entries? I mean, can we correct those quantities?
Okay. So what I understood from you is that they were using this minus thing earlier, because negative thing was allowed. So they had got some minus quantity when that was enabled. Now we are no longer enabled it, we disabled it. So now it is not come, but whatever is historically there, we need to correct it. Is that correct?
Yes, since ideally if that checkbox is not checked, then the core is should send some pop-up saying you don't have that much of quantity in your warehouse. Either, I mean, you cannot proceed with the transaction.
Yes.
So it doesn't give, and the stock balance is showing negative, though we have allow negative stock disabled. So if such scenarios, how do we have any thing to correct, and or something like that? That is one question, and the comparison between the balance quantity between two reports.
Okay. So see, the checkbox is there essentially, you know, so whenever you want to take some stock out from warehouse, you want to take a stock out, the stock is zero, you can't take it out if that thing is not clicked. So if you're clicking it, it allows you to do it, and once you do allow you to do that, you will have this negative stock in the balance. So that was what we see here. Now we have disabled it, so from now onwards it will not allow you to take out the stock. So if you pass the entry to take out the stock, it will give, it should give an error. But is it giving error to you now, or it is not giving the error?
Now it is giving error because this last entry is zero is there.
Yeah, so it is not allowing you to take stock out. So that is working fine.
Yeah, that is working fine. But before making this last entry, my warehouse was having only 400, not 500.
Okay.
But here the glitch is, I have made just this entry on 20th May and not on the same date.
Okay.
So it's fine if you can if we can go through again, and we can come up with in next session also answer is fine. But this is what I'm currently facing in this regarding the ERP Next reports. And if I see the lot many documentation available there, they somewhere clearly said that backdated is allowed. But in the coming version, in the 13 version, they have done some of the reposting done in the coding level. But I don't thing. So how it will be helpful to my use case currently I'm using. So that's
okay. So do you really want to know how, why this has happened, or do you want to know how to go about it now going forward? I mean, now you have no longer you're no longer using that negative thing. Now going forward, you'll not be using negative balances, and you already got zero balance. So do you want to know how to go ahead now going forward, or you are concerned about so what is your concern? Is it why this happened, or what should you do now?
Yes.
Now, what is your concern? Why it should happen, that you want to know, or what you should do now? What is, or do you want to know both?
Why this happened? Yeah, both.
Okay, fair enough. I think we'll catch offline in this 11:15. Just send me a message on Telegram.
Sure.
And we'll set up a time, and I guess we'll need to go a little more detail if you are interested to know why it has happened.
Sure. We can.
Sure.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks. Dhananjay, you raised your hand?
Yes, sir. I have done. Can I share my screen?
Yes, please.
Just want to know if right or something missing. This is my balance sheet. Can you hear me, sir?
Not yet. I think it will take some time.
Hello.
Yeah, I'm not seeing your screen yet.
Okay. Just a second.
Yeah, I'm not seeing your screen yet. Now it is coming.
Okay. My balance sheet.
Okay, so you have got cash in hand. Okay, you are not using a bank account, okay? You are using cash in hand directly?
Yeah, I am using cash in hand. I can modify it.
Okay, fair enough. I mean, since you're an accountant, you know what you're doing.
I selected cash instead of bank. I will alter it.
So that's fine. The stock asset is 372, that's correct. Just go down. Just look at the liabilities part. Yeah, you have got shareholder funds of 10 lakhs. That's correct. Can you show your cash flow statement? Okay, we also got a negative cash change in there. Just go down. Okay, there's nothing in the net cash from financing. Okay, is Vaishali there online? Vaishali, are you there online? Okay, so Dhananjay, since you're accountant, I'm actually asking you this question. So what has happened with Vaishali's case, it shows net cash from financing is 10 lakh.
Yeah, because, I just said that as opening balance 10 lakh, that's why it's been not appearing here.
But incidentally, we do not have that checkbox here, opening entries are included or not. I see the same thing what you see. So it looks like a version change. Maybe they have.
Because
it could be argued either way. You should either show that 10 lakh as a net cash from financing because it has come from stock, the owner's stock, owner's equity, or it could be shown as a zero. I don't know. Either way, it looks a good argument.
Okay.
But we don't know whether ERP Next is doing how it is really calculating that.
Maybe I have
old version
of ERP, that's why.
Yeah, no, that's fine. I mean, either way, we are okay as far as we understand what we are doing. So, your net cash from financing, it is not showing as 10 lakh.
Yeah.
same case with me. Even in my instance, I don't see that 10 lakh in that cash from financing, and we see negative change in cash.
The balance sheet report is showing that it's fair.
Sorry, I didn't get that.
Balance sheet report amounts are showing that it's fair, or need some change.
The balance sheet are good. Balance sheet and profit and loss, profit and loss is not applicable here anyway. Balance sheet numbers are showing correctly. In cash flow, I think there is a little challenge. You are not seeing this 10 lakh as a net cash from financing. That means that Vaishali is in our account, you are in my both. Whereas Vaishali's account, it is showing 10 lakh in net cash from financing. So net change in cash is different in Vaishali's ERP system and our next system. But I guess that is okay, but that's not a big problem also. But otherwise, I think things are pretty much in shape. Your temporary account, just show the chart of account just to confirm. I think it must be correct, but just check chart of accounts. Yeah, your temporary accounts is zero. Your stock in hand, your cash. Just go up, look at the stock adjustment is, so hold on, stock adjustment 372,000. What is your opening balance? What is your temporary account? Sure, temporary account.
Where is it?
Temporary account is zero. Okay, so that is zero. But your stock, the stock adjustment has come. Okay, can you just show your stock reconciliation thing? Actually, you did a material receipt. Oh, that's not correct.
That's why.
You didn't do stock reconciliation.
Okay.
You should have done stock reconciliation and make a opening stock.
Okay.
And then that way it will work out.
Okay.
So that is a correction that you need to do.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks. Okay. Since we're here, any other questions? Or should we close our call session now?
Sir?
Yes, Ramakrishna.
Can I share my screen?
Yeah, please.
Have changed the data, sir.
Yes. Your bank has got 66,27,000. Your stock assets are 3 lakh, right? Temporary accounts is zero. Your capital account, shareholder funds has got 10 lakhs. Looks pretty much in order. Good. Can you just show your balance sheet?
Yes, for sure.
Yeah, can just go down. Yeah, can just scroll up a little bit. So you have got Bank of Maharashtra 6,27,000 plus. Stock in hand is 3 lakhs, so that is 10 lakhs. Capital account is, shareholder fund is 10 lakhs, that's correct. Just show your cash flow statement. Okay, in your case also it's showing minus. Okay, just go down. Okay, just scroll down a little bit. Okay, fair enough. Can you just show stock ledger? Sorry, not general ledger. I mean, just show general ledger. Achha, when you did this stock reconciliation, you didn't can you just click on the voucher number?
This one, sir?
Yes, here. Yeah. Okay, so you selected purpose as stock reconciliation. Just go down. Okay, so you selected a purpose as stock reconciliation. You should have selected that as the opening stock. Okay, but what you have done, you have correctly selected the difference amount account, temporary opening. So result has not affected. I mean, we are getting the same right results per se. But this entry is not stock reconciliation entry, it's just opening stock entry. So that's why you in your stock ledger that you see that. But it is fine, it's not a big problem per se. But just to ensure that, you know, when you're using stock reconciliation screen for opening stock, you should have the purpose as opening stock. Now you can't change it, but that's fine. You could.
Okay.
Yeah, so that is fine. But otherwise, I think everything is perfect. You can actually go ahead and we can now.
Sir, can I change it? Can I edit it?
You can delete and create a new stock reconciliation request. That's fine. So that also actually should do that. Let us have a clean slate rather than carrying that issue. You can simply delete this. I guess you should be able to delete it. Once you create again, but again verify it and attempt at quiz number 4. You should get.
Have attempted.
So after you finish, you delete this, you know, create a new entry, stock reconciliation with opening stock, and then go for quiz number 4. There the questions will ask like, oh, check out your stock ledger, what is the amount there, check out your this thing, what is the amount there. So you put all the amounts there. If you get 100% marks, that means you are done, correctly done.
Okay. Huh? Okay, thanks.
Okay then, thank you. Okay, anyone else? Should we close the session now?
Yeah, Shrikant, we can close the session. So guys, those who have not completed, it is a really a sincere request that we are going to complete it before the next session. And you will get it validated from the Dr. Shrikant. Then only we will move to the next session, else we might need to wait for and hold on the next session till that time. And try to be communicative on a group. People are asking you continuously and forcing you guys to update the assignment. But somewhere we are not seeing, except one or two replies, we are not seeing any kind of responses. So we expect that you will communicate and do the required assignments and complete the activities. Specifically Ravi, Shubhangi, we haven't seen any responses from these guys. Okay, yeah, Shrikant.
Yeah, so just in continuation, I have not seen any response from Ravi, Shubhangi, Anirudh, Snehal and Swati. Five, yeah.
Okay.
And Sile is not well, that is what Vaishali told us. So
all right,
we don't know. But otherwise, this five, we have not got response. Others are work in progress. And once they appear for quiz 4, and if they get 100% or at least 80%, at least 80% is what they should get. One question, there could be different answer. Then they are done. That is kind of indication. So
okay.
How do we know that they are done? It's by. So they have to put the right numbers there in the quiz, and then we'll know that they are done. So we will check the quiz response. If we see that people have scored 80%, all of them, then we know that they are done. So we don't need to do any other check.
Okay. Okay. Fine. Great. That's great.
Okay then. So let me close the session now. Thank you very much. See you on day after tomorrow.
Yeah. Thank you, Shrikant.